The Young and the Restless spoilers tease that Victoria Newman will cause some big headwinds in the Newman family during the week of August 17 to 21. Victoria will work out her plans, and Jack will be fully involved. We should note that recently Jack and Victor have not been doing the best deal, so this could signal that the big announcement about Victoria has it may be something Victor may not be pleased with, or at least it may not be in the direction Victor often chose his company. But this is a huge power move from Victoria's side, signaling that she's in power, not Victor. So what's Victoria's big announcement going to be? One might think it would involve putting Adam in his place or even killing AJ Montalvo when he was a boy. But with Jack involved, it can be doubted that he will stand by and assist Victoria in his quest to ruin Adam's reputation. Perhaps we're looking at some sort of Newman, Jobboat alliance, which is something Victoria may be doing to build her own game in the city of Genoa. We'll see what happens here, but it looks like Adam will quickly get a message that he used to be where the Newman business was interested. It will be interesting to see how Victor handles the major changes Victoria will lead at Newman, especially if they end up negatively impacting Adam. One thing is certain, Newman will find himself in more chaos. As Y and our viewers already know, Victoria finally returns to the CEO position at Newman Enterprises, and she's not content to simply take back her position, she wants to go back openly and make a mark. And in the city of Genoa, it seems. The new Y&R preview video shows Victoria looks huge and responsible as she defiantly tells Nikki Newman, "Right now I'm running Newman Enterprises and this is the decision I made. Given. Out." Nikki retorted, "You can't go out there and blow everything up." But that won't stop Victoria, who will quickly hold a press conference and announce some of the major changes at Newman Enterprises. All in her direction. During the press conference, Victoria will announce that leadership is about accountability, and when Adam Newman and Victor Newman watch the meeting take place on TV, Adam will be quick to note that Victor's message has been received and that Victoria is calling the police right now. "We'll look at that, son," Victor noted. So, what are these big changes Victoria will make at the Newman Enterprise? Well, according to the Y&R spoilers, it will involve Jack Abbott and perhaps Jobboat as well, as Victoria will summon Jack for a meeting that leaves him very curious. The Cameron Grimes star teases that her character Mariah is trying to protect her mother Sharon before it's too late. Here's what she has to say. Amelia said she was a bit overwhelmed when participating in character testing. "About 7 other girls came to the audition, and I would have to challenge many actors," she recalls. "I was the last one to check, and I had all of these people come up and say to me, 'I really want you to take it. Here's how you should play it.' So I waited around, very worried, and in the end, I said, 'Ah, get me out of here. I can't do this. I'm sure they'll find someone among the girls auditioning.'" Amelia continued, "I had everything prepared. I was in dressing room of Don Diamant, and Marnie Seda was standing there with a large basket filled with chips and cookies. She was like, 'Snack?' I was like, 'Oh, God, she knows I'm going. She could say I was risky with the flight. Heinle couldn't stand the temptation of delicious food. I'm not really hungry, but I think it's a sign that I should stay because I'm out the door. There was so much pressure and I wasn't interested in sitting there anymore. But I felt I couldn't have a snack and then left, so I stayed. And the rest is history." And there you have it. As of press time, reports say Y&R's cast and crew are back to work, which means fans should expect to see new episodes by the end of August or at the earliest. Is the first week of September. We will be sure to update you with all the latest information as it appears. At the Abbott mansion, Abby looked at Jack with concern. She surmised that he was thinking about Dina, and he confirmed that he cares about his mother, their family and Theo. Jack said that Kyle told Abby that Theo was fired. Jack questioned whether the idea of having Kyle and Theo fight pressured Theo to cross the line. Abby points out that Theo has been in trouble since he arrived in the city of Genoa, but Jack dismisses that Theo is family and deserves a second chance. Jack scoffs at the idea that he and Abby know nothing about stirring up trouble. Abby sympathizes that Jack has been torn about Theo, and she thinks it might be too much to hope Theo will see Abbott as a family. Jack explains that he wants to give his mother one last gift by introducing her to his nephew while replacing Theo's family that has passed away. Abby gently assured Jack that he did, and that the radioactive dust belonged to Theo. She advised Jack not to worry about Theo because Theo always landed on his feet. At the guild, Theo played a video on the phone he filmed to show he was looking for the next big thing. He turned it off and muttered that the first step was to redo the video. A waiter placed a takeout bag on the bar, and Theo noticed that the receipt was from Chancellor Communications. He excitedly jotted down a piece of paper and shoved it in his luggage bag. At Chancellor Communications, Lily looked at some of the changes Billy made to some of the contracts they signed with Amanda the day before, and she wondered what prompted his new caution. Lily recounted that during his meeting with Amanda, Billy showed respect instead of being stubborn. Billy insisted that he respected Amanda's expertise, but Lily did sense an unpleasant vibe between Billy and Amanda. Lily questioned if it was a mistake to hire a lawyer. Then, Billy came back after lunch, and Lily complained that he dodged her earlier question. Billy argued that he was nothing more than an Amanda supporter, but Lily tried to hear the full story that happened between them. Billy remembers that Amanda was a good friend of his when his relationship with Victoria ended, but he insists that he and Amanda weren't romantically involved. Lily asked if either of them was aroused. Billy admits that there were times when he thought something was going on there, but Amanda was too smart to interfere with him. Billy swears he's fine working with Amanda, but he's just adapting to new professional dynamics. Billy boasted that no one could hold back his visionary abilities. He began to open his belongings and found Theo's piece of paper. Billy announced that they had received an offer from a potential Abbott family fugitive. Billy and Lily went through the list of names Theo had submitted and she recognized some of the influencers and bloggers they wanted to work with. She assumed the notes meant Theo had access to them, and she turned to her computer to look up names she didn't know. Billy explained that Theo was a kind of Abbott family member, the child Dina abandoned to adopt. Billy recalls that Theo and Kyle used to be friends in New York, but the relationship broke down. Lily thinks it might not be Theo's fault. Billy thinks that the piece of paper means that the job Jack gave Theo at Jobot has also collapsed. Lily was impressed with the names on Theo's list, and she complimented him on his talent. She questioned how big the risk Theo would be, and Billy shared that he warned Kyle that Theo was a threat. Meanwhile, Theo watched his second attempt at making a video about getting back into business, and he boredly called it a lame. He got up when the phone rang. Billy asked Theo immediately to Chancellor Communications if he wanted to play 10 minutes. According to the reply that he only needed 5, and he jumped out. According to the office, Billy introduced him to Lily, who complimented Theo's unusual way of working. Theo says he likes to stand out from the crowd, but Billy compared it to a square pin in the round hole. According to the statement, he has heard great things about Chancellor Communications, but Lily says she has the impression that he is working for Jobot. According to the statement, he continued as it was not a match. Theoretically, it's too collective and he prefers to have freedom of speech. Billy warns that Theo's days are passing. Theo confidently claims that he understands young people's preferences and preferences, and clickbait is no longer as effective as before. He came up with the idea of Chancellor Communications' targeted demographic approach using his contacts. Theo realized that his 5 minutes had run out, and he thanked Billy and Lily for their time. Billy stopped him from leaving and revealed that Tracy had informed him that Theo had been fired. Billy dryly invited according to repost, like or share the truth. According to the claims, he was fired, and Billy scolded him for lying about it. According to the argument, he had limited time to make a pitch, and Lily asked what happened. According to claims that Kyle had kept it for him since Theo was hired, so the post was hung on the wall when Jack set up a contest between them. Theo made it clear that he didn't blame Jack for anything and that he wasn't lying when he said it was inappropriate. According to the news, Chancellor felt more fond of his niche, and he insisted that he could come up with names on the list and more. He thought he wouldn't be standing there if Billy and Lily didn't care, and he thanked them again and left. Billy admits that Theo has kept an eye on the relationships and talents Chancellor needed. Lily is concerned that Theo lied about him being fired, but Billy understood why Theo wanted to make himself better. Lily reminded Billy that he said Theo was in trouble, but Billy admitted that for some reason, he liked Theo. Lily said in surprise that she and Billy had changed sides. Billy was so impressive that Theo never stumbled, even as Billy threw everything he had at him. He wanted to give Theo a chance. At Crimson Lights, Theo hesitantly approaches Jack and tells him they have unfinished work. Theo regretted him running out of the conference room after being caught trying to make Jack's old presentation his own. Theo shared that he didn't want his old job back and he thought coming to Jobot was a mistake. Jack was pleased that Theo realized he had burned the bridge, and he wished he had foreseen the conflict between Kyle and Theo. Theo feels relieved to be back in the world again, pulling his own weight instead of handing everything over to him for DNA. Jack supposed more DNA was needed for the Abbotts to keep Jobot overhead, but he thinks he could make a similar statement that day if he was caught, despite his carelessness. More personality. It is possible that they both inherited the same problem gene. Remember to keep an eye on Young and the Restless, you don't want to miss out on anything this week. And remember to keep the YNR channel open to keep up with all the latest YNR updates, interesting news and revelations.
Abby can even become a truly dependent couple. To Abby.